How many of you have ever been so low, so despondent, so depressed, that the enemy tried to make you feel like the Lord had forgotten about you? I mean, I know we don't have that many folk that'll be honest, but sometimes we fall into a spiritual rut and it seems like we just can't come out. But there's a song that Deacon Glasby used to sing that Dr. Oates is singing this morning, is a word of assurance. And that is that I know beyond a shadow of a doubt that regardless of what's going on in our life, there's one thing I'm certain about. One thing that I can deposit in my checking account. And that is that Jesus cares. How many of you know that Jesus cares? And sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down, and sometimes I'm almost level to the ground. But I regain strength and hope because I know that Jesus cares. Sing the song, Dr. Oates. Sing quiet. How many of you know he cares? Luther Barnes personalized it. He said, I know he cares, and I know he cares for me. And you know, some of us want to pretend that we are too blessed to be stressed and don't want to ever admit that we have some hard times. But I like the fact that even when I'm up and I'm down, I still know that Jesus cares. Thank you, choir. Thank you, Dr. Oates. Oh, yes. If I didn't believe that with assurance, I'd go home and sit under the tree and give up. But I know he cares. Thank you, choir. He cares for me. The scripture that was read by Deaconess Nicholson is where I'm preaching from this morning. I would ask the Lord for a repeat of 7:45, but I ask him to do what he chooses to do at this hour and grant us a rhema word for this house. I want to warn you, if you think small, this sermon is not for you. If you are content in your matchbox, this sermon is not for you. But if you believe that our God can do even greater things, then this sermon is for you. Isaiah chapter 54, verses 2 through 4 from the King James Version. Enlarge the place of thy tent. Let them stretch forth the curtains of thine habitations. Spare not. Lengthen thy cords and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left. And thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not. Listen now, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame. For thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth. Y'all got to hear that. What he's saying is what's coming is going to be so powerful, it's going to make you forget what happened in the past. And shall not remember the reproach of thy widowhood anymore. I want to talk this morning from a subject using four words embedded in the text. Enlarge, stretch, lengthen, and strengthen. Enlarge, somebody's ready to hear some preaching. Stretch, lengthen, and strengthen. Enlarge, stretch, lengthen, and strengthen. Enlarge. Stretch, lengthen, and strengthen. Enlarge, stretch, lengthen, and strengthen. God, we thank you for this privilege to stand and rightfully divide your word of truth. We didn't come this morning to tickle anyone's ears, nor with any false prophecies, but we come this morning standing on your word. Your word that says enlarge, your word that says stretch, your word that says lengthen, and your word that says strengthen. Speak now, for your servant is listening. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Amen. Sister Celia Mitchell, how would you react if you heard the Lord say loudly and clearly and without interruption, Make room for greater. Prepare for an increase. Tonya Hankins, how would you respond if you heard the Lord loud and clear say to you, make room for greater. Prepare for an increase. Myra, how would you respond if you heard the Lord clearly say, make room for greater. Prepare for an increase. I haven't touched anybody on this side. Pat Waddell, how would you respond if you heard the Lord say without a shadow of a doubt, Pat, make room for greater. Prepare. Somebody's getting it. For an increase. Would you take the mindset of a skeptic and allow skepticism and doubt to rob you of the fulfillment of the promise? Would you write it off as another prophetic message from a preacher that gives me hope but eventually lets me down? How would you react if you heard the Lord say, make room for greater? And I guess someone is sitting here saying, well, Pastor, I'm waiting to hear it. That would be good news. You just heard it. If you were listening, the Lord said, enlarge the place of your tent. I'm going to preach if you talk to me. Stretch forth the curtains of thine habitations. Spare not. Don't hold back. Lengthen your cords and strengthen thy stakes. This is a post-exilic text after the Israelites came out of exile. And they had been in exile for a number of years, 70 plus years. And now they have returned home. But what do you do, Sister Porter, when you return home and all the things that were in place prior to your leaving are now gone? How do you rebuild hope when you've gone through a season of drought? Somebody sitting here this morning, the truth be told, you're doing everything you can to keep from crying because the sermon is right on your page. Pastor, I'm not getting what you're saying. When you go through seasons and it looks like every time you build up confidence and hope and increase your faith to think that perhaps things are getting ready to change, you end up going back into that same depressed state where you just don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. Phyllis, it would be great if you could rebound with confidence. But when you are uncertain of the future and don't really know what the future holds specifically for you, it leaves you in a state of, again, I'm going to say depression. I don't know why the Lord keep putting that word in my spirit. Because it seems like you've just been in this state year after year. And every new year, you approach it with hope and faith, believing that perhaps 17 would be better than 16. The 17 will make you forget about what happened in 14 and 15. Can I get somebody to help me? And the last thing you want is a recurrence of what happened before, something that drained you of all your enthusiasm, all of your energies. And then out of nowhere, God speaks. Y'all do know he'll do that. And speaks using metaphors. Pastor, any metaphors? You can't take this literally. He talks about Phyllis, the barren woman. The woman who has not been able to have a child. And he lets her know that what's getting ready to happen is bigger than you could ever imagine. I wish I had somebody to talk to me. He lets her know that, and not only her, but he refers to Israel as a her. Talk to me, somebody. That what I'm getting ready to do for you is going to be so large that your mindset cannot contain it. That in order for you to really digest, Leslie, what I have for you, you've got to first of all take me out of your box. Oh, they talked with me at 7:45 this morning. What do you mean, Pastor? To take me out of your box. Get rid of the limitations. Oh, I wish I had somebody to help me. So I would say that the size of your box is directly proportional to your faith. And if you are expecting a blessing that's the size of a shoebox, then that's what you ought to give to God. But is there anyone here this morning who knows that you don't have a box in your possession that is equivalent to the size of what God has? Oh, I wish you could see yourselves, and some of you doing this. Pastor Henry, this is just another hype. This is just another promise. This is something that's going to make me go home and get my hopes up and then another letdown. The letdown is not going to be on God's part. Because God has spoken. And somebody said, let the church say amen. So the bottom line is, do you believe that God can do what he promised? Maybe I need to remind you of Ephesians 3:20. That God is able to do what? If you ask here, God will do it here. Because he says, I'll go beyond what you ask. And then he said, I am going to move you to a level that you don't have to ask me. All you got to do is think it. And if you can believe, I'll make it happen based upon your thoughts. So here it is, clear as crystal. Are y'all with me? Enlarge means to make larger. Stretch means to enlarge or distend by force. Lengthen means to make longer. Strengthen means to make stronger. Y'all don't hear me. Pastor, and I'm not getting this. God is saying, I'm ready. And he's waiting on you to say, bring it on. But Phyllis, the criteria is you got to make room. Come on. He said, you enlarge. Y'all don't hear me. You stretch. You lengthen. And you strengthen. I said, wow. Pastor, where you going? You see, trust is not figuring it out. In order to move to greater levels of faith, it is important that you try not to figure it out. You can't calculate or reason as it pertains to God. You are only required to do one thing, and that is to trust and believe. I wish I had somebody to help me. So, Reverend Rasmus, if God said it, I believe it. That settles it. Stretch. Come on, somebody. Enlarge. Lengthen. And strengthen. Pastor, need to slow it down. Let's talk for a minute. You see, Ms. Kermit, there's a vast difference between this text and the prayer of Jabez. Jabez asked God to enlarge my territory. God heard his prayer, and God did it. Sister Walker, in this text, no one is asking. You got it? God is saying, I'm going to do it. Luzella, just because I want to do it. I'm going to do it because I know it's what you need for this season. So in order to prepare for it, I want you to get ready, start enlarging, start tearing some walls down, start stretching. Take what you have and lengthen it and prepare for what I'm getting ready to do. The study Bible says this is future glory. Wow. So where are we going? I'm glad you want to go because I'm ready. And here it is, just as plain as day. The opening line of this verse or this chapter says, listen, sing, O barren that did not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud, that did not travail with the child. Listen, for more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife. Leslie, you look puzzled. What he's simply saying is this: I'm going to give more children to the barren woman than the woman who already has children. Can I get somebody to help me? What God is saying is, when I get through blessing you this time, it's going to be more than you can ever imagine. But there is one criteria. Now, somebody over here is not listening because they're just sitting there. So maybe I can talk to these folk over here. Here it is. He said, rejoice and go ahead and sing. Now, I hope I didn't hurt your feelings over here, but I'm trying to get you to see something. He opens the chapter by saying, sing and rejoice. But it hasn't happened yet. So my first point this morning is rejoice before you see it. Now, y'all didn't get that. Because as traditional Baptists, we are accustomed to thanking the Lord for the food that's already on the table. But the Lord said to me as I was preparing the message that you need to share something that's extremely important with the congregation. When you thank me for a blessing you've already received, that's gratitude. But when you praise me before you see it, that's faith. Y'all don't hear. If I promise, let me pull up something. If I promise, come here, to give you $10. Are y'all with me? And you go ahead and start saying hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Because it's not in your hands yet. That says that you believe that I'm going to do what I promise. If I give it to you and you say thank you, that's just gratitude. But God says, I'm looking for a few good folk that'll stand up and give me praise for what hasn't happened yet. You don't see it? I know it's being recorded and I really don't care. But I wish I had about 15 folk that believe God and I'll go ahead and tell him thank you. I'm talking about folk that'll run your head back and go ahead and say glory and thank you in advance for what I believe you're getting ready to do. I haven't seen it. It's not tangible. I can't put my hands on it. But because you said so, I hate to show you how to praise him, but maybe somebody needs an example. I don't see it. I can't touch it. But God, I give you glory. I give you the highest praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because help is on the way. God, I feel an enlargement. I feel I'm being stretched. I feel I'm getting ready to see something lengthen. Somebody feels it coming. Somebody know God will do what he said he will do. Somebody know heaven and earth will pass away, but his words will. Somebody knows that God will do what he said he will do. God said, you've been waiting with your hands out, getting ready to receive. But God says, I want you to put those hands together and go ahead and bless my name. Go ahead and give me glory. Can I get somebody to help me? Sing. Oh, barren woman, sing. I know it hasn't happened yet, but sing. Rejoice. Enlarge, stretch, and lengthen. Enlarge, stretch, and lengthen. Get out of your box. Do something that's not natural. Enlarge. Stretch. And limit. God said you've been on a small, desolate, and impoverished place. You've cried so much till your pillows are continuously wet with tears. But God said, in this season that is approaching, I want you to prepare to receive what I have for you. Don't you think because I've slowed down, I'm finished preaching? But God says clearly, enlarge. Pastor Henry, you're doing a lot of repetition today. Stretch. Lengthen. And strengthen. Pastor Henry, I am afraid to step out on faith. I'm afraid to open that new business because what if I fail? What if things don't go the way that I plan? He says it twice. Haddon Robinson says if God says something twice, he wants you to get the point. For thou shalt not be ashamed. Verse 3, he says, don't fear. Don't be afraid to step out. Don't be afraid to get you some moving boxes. Don't be afraid to take a chance. Don't be afraid to sign a note. Enlarge. Stretch. And lengthen. And I'll deal with strengthen in a minute. But the Lord said this to me. And it stole the house at 7:45. But I hope you hear it. Because it's going to be an insult to your friends. Are y'all with me? Reject the attitude of smallness. Sonia, when you got a vision and God has spoken provision, you got to be careful as to first of all who you share your vision with. Y'all don't hear me. can't tell everybody what God has deposited in your spirit because some folk can't contain it. Child, you stay right here. Don't you be so daring to do something foolish when this economy is so uncertain. You know, we just got a new president. And Lord knows we don't know what the future is going to hold. So I'm going to keep my little nest egg in my mason jar under my bed. And I'm not going to take any chances. God said, enlarge. Brother Adams, he said, stretch and lengthen. So what do you mean, Pastor Henry? You telling us to reject the attitude of smallness? That sounds a tad bit arrogant. God says, if you hear the words that I use, they all pertain to something that is larger, expanding. So Phyllis, you cannot settle for someone speaking little words. Y'all not talking to me this morning. You will always have naysayers. And even now, there's somebody sitting on your pew. I don't believe that. They close their minds to the idea of greater as soon as they heard the text. And because they don't want you to go any higher, they had rather hold on to you like a group of crabs. Pastor, and let me back up for a minute. I can't see this because I don't know of any place in the scripture where the Lord told folk to rejoice. Are y'all with me? Before it happened. And Jericho was straightly shut. No one could go in and no one could come out. And God told his people to march around the walls of Jericho every day for seven. I wish I had somebody to help me. And on the seventh day, God told them to praise him before the walls. If you're waiting on the walls to collapse, then all you can do is show him your gratitude. But if you praise him prior to the walls coming down, then you're showing him your faith. Reject the attitude of smallness. It's four of y'all. What y'all talking? Okay, you the only one that says something. You expected more than enough? Yes, sir. All right, I want you two to hang out with me today. Yes, sir. I don't know whether you've listened to all of the sermons in the new year, but there's been a common thread. It's been mindsets. There's no need of me taking these two. That's dead weight. Y'all didn't get it. They didn't even have enough faith to speak up. So why are you hanging out with folk who are still thinking small? I'm just hanging up on that. I heard the Lord say, enlarge, stretch, lengthen. Your neighbor will tell you, take it slow. Don't move in haste. What did the Lord say? Enlarge. Stretch. Lengthen. And strengthen. Mia, if you know that something's coming that's going to take more space than you have on that pew, then you've got to prepare. So if you know it's going to sit on that pew, then you need to slide closer to Miss Sonia. What you doing? Making room. And I know somebody said, Pastor, you don't appease me with those little simple illustrations. I trust God. God said, enlarge. God knows I wish I had somebody to talk to me. God says, stretch. Whoa. Lengthen. Wow. Reject the attitude of smallness. I'm done with small-minded people. How you gonna tell the sheep that you're done with them? Don't take this statement wrong. But if the Lord said that he's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think, is mean we don't serve a small-minded God. He said, John 10:10, I have come that you might have life and have it. Reject the attitude of smallness. The Lord slowed me down. And number three, make room for greater. Here it is. For thou shall, not may, break forth on the right hand and on the left. Thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither shall thou be confounded. For I will not put you to shame. For thou shalt forget the shame of your youth. That what I'm going to do will be so great that you'll forget about the hurt, the pain, the frustrations that you've already experienced. That what I have is greater than what you've already been through. Make room for greater. In my house from 7 to 8 o'clock, our eyes are tied to the TV. Mrs. Henry loves Wheel of Fortune. I don't. I've loved Jeopardy. The other night, sermon was finished, but Dr. Graham, I needed a closing. And Alex Trebek's, rather the double jeopardy question, was one that I could not answer. I missed it. The question said, describe or name an organ in a woman's body that expands up to 500 times its size. No one answered. And Alex Trebek gave the answer. He said, it is the uterus. I said, Lord, if I close the sermon talking about a uterus, they're going to fire me on the spot. But the Lord said, I hired you, and you speak the words that I've given you. Once, can I get somebody to help me? Around the 12th week of a woman's pregnancy, the uterus, which is the size of a grapefruit, realizes that it has to make room for what's on the way. So it begins to expand, to stretch, and to lengthen. Can I get a witness?
In fact, the gynecologist is able to tell the woman just how many weeks pregnant she is by the size and the length of the uterus as it expands in centimeters. I wish I had somebody can see where I'm going. But as the baby grows, the uterus expands because the uterus has to hold the baby. Somebody ought to talk to me in here. So therefore, if the uterus is wise enough, I know I'm talking about it, it ain't object, but think about it, to start stretching, to start expanding in preparation for what's on the way, then I ought to have at least five folk that'll go ahead and give God praise. Somebody that can feel it down on the inside. Somebody that feels the kicking. Somebody that feels the enlargement.
What the Lord said. I wrestled with the last one because it doesn't synchronize with the first three verbs where he says strengthen it. The Message Bible drives it home. He simply says this: tie it down. Secure it. What I'm going to do for you, hallelujah, it's going to be so large that you're going to need stakes to tie it down. And God says, I want you to secure it because I don't want any of the excess to fall in the wrong hands. Because anyone who has not prepared to receive it is not ready to hold it. And you don't want to put anything in the hands of somebody who's not ready to receive it. Wow. Enlarge it. Make room. Get rid of that. Sister, you mind pulling me? Phyllis, you mind pulling her? Stretching hurts. Oh, stretching hurts. And the Lord said, that's what some of you have been going through. The stretching. But he said, I didn't stretch you to hurt you. I stretched you to prepare you for what I've got coming. Anything that comes too easy, it's not worth the praise. But when you can feel the enlargement, when you can feel the stretching, when you can feel the lengthening, somebody's been through hell and hot water. God says, I didn't take you through it because I was upset with you. But rather, I'm preparing you for greater. Jekyll and Clyde said, greater. But there was one requirement, and that is saying, rejoice. Bless the name of Jesus before you see it. Pastor Henry, I don't think I've done this in years. Come down now, but I hear God saying, when you lift up your hands and start glorifying him in advance and praising him before it happens, you got some folk on your pew who will argue they want you to sit somewhere else next Sunday. They're too noisy. I don't want them around me. In fact, you can go ahead and tell them now if you don't like the way I praise them. Then you choose to sit somewhere else next Sunday. But I'm getting ready for an enlargement. I'm getting ready to be stretched. The doors of the church are open. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! What's coming is greater than anything you can ever imagine. I heard the Lord loud and clear, and I know his voice. He said, Tara, I've spoken it, but it is their responsibility to receive it, listen, and to act on it. Because if you don't act on it, it's just another sermon. Enlarge. Stretch. Lengthen. And strength. And you thought the Lord was mad with you. You thought he was upset with you. You thought that he had forgotten about you. He says, I'm using all of this to prepare you. To prepare you, to prepare you, to prepare you, to get you ready for greater. As we all stand all over the house, enlarge your tent, make room because greater is coming. Stretch it. Lengthen it. And then when you finish, make sure you tie it down.